give a quick demonstration today of the importance of depth on how wet a soil stays or how dry it can be. And this demonstration is actually based on a paper published by Dr. Art Spummel from the University of Illinois back in the late 70s. And he used this demonstration of his example to show the importance of depth and potting media for different types of pots. And the analogy used was a sponge, this, which is the sponge itself would be kind of like the soil matrix, you know, the particles and all that. And then all the spaces in the sponge that aren't connected would be similar air pores and pores that held water. Now obviously, the size of the pores dictate how much water's being held. But to give you an example of this demonstration was that we soaked one of the sponges shown here, and I put it above this screen and have allowed it to drain. So it's basically saturated. And this analogy would be similar to a root zone mix in a putting green. What I'm going to do first, as you can see here, there's no water moving. And if I turn it like this, you can see the water dripping out. So in this position, although it's the same area, the water is draining now more because of basically it's a taller profile. So I'm going to let that kind of settle here for a second. Now I'm going to take it this, and notice now too, when I turn it this direction, more water flows out. And the idea, for example, on a putting green, you would know at the base here, it's going to be pretty saturated. If the root zone mix is too shallow, not deep enough, then it's going to remain too wet. And if it's too deep, then the surface part will become too dry. So within the specifications, when you're building USGA or any putting green and using the root zone mix, the depth is extremely important to a large extent, covering how wet or dry that mix is going to be.